Morning, ma'am.
Good morning. Good morning,
everyone. Morning, ma'am.
So, successfully completed parts of speech and successfully completed content and form words, right? So, I have told you children, content and form words, it is, we can label all the nouns, all the verbs, not all the verbs, except auxiliary verbs, okay? So, verbs, main verbs, nouns, adjectives and adverbs are examples for content words, right? At the same time, pronouns, prepositions, conjunctions and interjections are form words. And also I said WH word, if it is used in the form of a question word, that is coming under the content word category. And the words like NO, no, NOT, not, all the negatives are also examples for content words. Okay. So we said there are content words, and these content words are stressed words in English grammar. And we have functional words, and the functional words are non-stressed words, which we are using as a to set your structure, to set your language.
Content word, never.
Yes, never is a content word. Never is a content word. Yes, yes, because it is a negative word, right? Never is a content word. All these words are content words in English grammar. Okay, okay, children. So we completed this one, the content words and form words and parts of speech in general. So next topic for you is the familiar one. You know it very well. That is pronouns in details. That we are going to learn about first person pronouns, second person pronouns, third person pronouns. This is your very familiar. Last year you learned last year, right? At the same time, three cases under the pronouns. Okay, we learned there are three cases under the pronoun: nominative case, objective case, and possessive cases, right? Do you remember? Do you remember the everyone?
Ma'am.
Yes. So let me share the screen for you children. Let us talk about pronouns. Okay. Pronouns, okay, as you know very well, pronouns are just placed before or it takes the place of a noun. It is used in the form of a substitute. Okay. So pronouns are small words used instead of noun in a sentence. Once we start a sentence, we are normally starting our sentence with a noun, okay, or with a particular name of a person, or maybe with the name of a particular thing, or name of a particular I can tell you the Mount Everest, right? The Mount Everest is actually a mountain. We are using the Mount Everest. It's a proper noun, okay? It is very high. Okay, it is very high. So there I have used it, the word. It, the pronoun, just used in the form of a substitute to the noun. Okay, so pronouns are used instead of nouns in a sentence to avoid the repetition of nouns. Okay, what are pronouns, children? Pronouns are small words like I, you, we, they are some examples of pronouns. Okay, so these pronouns are used to avoid the repetition of nouns in a sentence. Am I clear? So yes, what are pronouns? Pronouns are small words used instead of nouns in a sentence. Okay. So what are pronouns, children? Fida, Fatima, can you explain what is a pronoun? Can you give me some example for pronouns also with definition? Fida, Fatima. Yes, Nandita Anil. She's raising her hand. Nandita. Nandita, please tell me what are, can you define a pronoun?
Yes, ma'am.
What are pronouns? I think she's facing network issue.
Ma'am, can I say?
I'm moving to the next person, that is Krishna. Krishna, can you hear me? Yes, Krishna, speak a little louder and adjust your camera. I can see only your right eye. Yes, Krishna. Now, Krishna, you please tell me what are pronouns in English grammar. Can you define a pronoun? Devak Menon?
Hello, ma'am.
Yes, Nandita?
Yeah. Ma'am, can you hear me?
I can hear you. Okay. Now, the question is to... The question is actually to Rana Fatima. Rana, please tell me, please define a pronoun. Can you define a pronoun now?
Ma'am, can I?
Rena, I cannot hear you.
Can
Rena,
I say
I'm sorry. Yes, Pia Maria. Pia Maria.
Ma'am, pronouns are the words used to avoid repetition of nouns.
This is used instead of noun in a sentence, right? Pronouns are the small words which we are using instead of a noun in a sentence to avoid the repetition of the nouns. Okay, to avoid the repetition, instead of using Rena, 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 Rena all the time, I can use she, her, hers, you, and all, right? So I am avoiding the repetition of noun with the help of a pronoun. Okay, so now a pronoun that is of two numbers, okay? You know, you are very clear, you know, there are two types, two number under pronouns, right? It has a singular number, it has a plural number. Pronouns can be categorized or classified under two numbers, okay? Singular number, singular means one, okay? The noun, he. I'm talking about Ahil Samir, he, only one person, right? I'm talking about Adil Samir, his, right? Only one person, right? I'm talking to you, Adil. So I can say you is also used to show one person. It represents one person, singular number, right? So the noun, the pronouns are classified under two numbers, singular numbers and plural numbers. Singular means one, plural means more than one, okay? Singular means one, plural means more than one. So we are friends. Okay, this class is 6C classroom. So we are friends means me, the teacher, or I, the teacher, and you, the children, are friends. Right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes or no?
Yes,
so
ma'am.
So we, it represents more than one. Two, three, four, five. Now I have here, how many participants here today in the class?
30.
There are 30 participants. So these 31, we 31 are friends, including me. So we, it shows more than one. Okay, so pronouns are classified under two numbers, and you know, singular number and plural number. Singular number stands for one, plural number stands for more than one. Okay, so he, one person, we, more than one person. She, one person, they, more than one person. See, look at here, you. I can use you for singular number and also with plural number. How? See, if I want to introduce you class, okay, the class 6C, you children, see, you children, you come here, children. Like I am just using you here to show that more than one. So you, the pronoun, can be used in the form of singular. At the same time, you, the pronoun, can be used in the form of plural in a sentence. Like, I'm talking to you, Pooja. Pooja, I'm talking to you. So there is only one child. I have used you because I want to show that Pooja is my friend, right? So Pooja, you are my friend. Okay. I can also say that children, you are my friends. 6C children, you are my friend. So you can be used to show singular subject at the same time plural subject. Yes, Anthony?
And then yours. Yours.
You?
And then yours.
Yours. Yours. Okay, yours loving. Yours loving son. Okay, yours loving son. So that is also a second person pronoun. Second person, first person, persons will talk later. Okay, so his, there. His means his favorite game or his favorite food. Ahil Samir's favorite food. His favorite food is?
Pizza.
His favorite food is?
Pizza.
What?
Pizza.
Pizza.
Pizza. My God, most modern child. I thought you may say that I love to eat rice and curry. We are all Indians, right? Why we are always preferring pizza and all? Pizza, it's not good for health.
And junk food.
These are coming samosa. Under the category called junk food. Samosa also fried one. It's not good for health.
Yes, ma'am.
The people, the vendors or the people, those who are actually frying samosas are using the same oil for months.
Yes, ma'am.
So it is not good for health. If you want a samosa, you do one thing, tell your papa and ama to make some for you. Okay. Today, if you want a Pangalina relics, want a samosa, just support your mother take some dove and make a samosa by just supporting your mother. You can, ma'am, you will be getting very delicious samosa from home.
Ma'am, I like cucumber also.
Cucumber. Cucumber is wrong usage. It is cucumber. Okay, cucumber. You like to eat cucumber. Salad, vegetable salad can be prepared. Ma'am. Okay, fruit salad also. How to prepare a fruit salad? You're applying cream and all. I'm from a very normal family background, so I use only honey. Cream and all, not even used. Yes, I'm using honey.
I only put salt.
In fruit salad. Bravo. Excellent. See,
ma'am, ma'am, my mother used power outage, power gone.
Or connective tissues.
Not
connective tissues.
Power failure.
Yes.
Hello, ma'am. Ma'am has sent message.
Please stay online.
Friend is the host.
Friend Joby is the host. Sorry, but we speak in town.
Where's the man? Power failure.
Yeah. Did ma'am king?
No.
Let us see. We were talking about the pronouns, right? We discussed
ma'am,
the
your video is
number
off.
Pronoun.
Ma'am, your camera's off.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. Okay, we were talking about singular number of pronouns and also plural numbers, right? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now ma'am. Let us talk about there are three persons. Okay, there are three
person,
persons.
Second person, third
yes,
person.
First person, second person,
third person. Person.
Are there? Okay.
Yes,
and
ma'am.
All these are categorized. See, you know, you are familiar with personal pronouns. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
We are labeling all these pronouns like I, we, he, she, they, all called as personal pronouns in English grammar. Why it is called a personal pronoun?
Ma'am, because it uses as personal.
It represents a or it represents persons, different persons, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Suppose if you are, if see, I am the person, I am a teacher here, I am teaching you English grammar, right? So who is talking to you? I am talking, right? So the person who is talking is said to be the first person. Am I clear? So
yes, ma'am.
I said, I only said we are friends, right? So here yes. I am the person who is talking, right? So the person talking is said to be the first person pronouns in English grammar. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
It was already discussed last year, right? We had a discussion
yes,
about
yes,
this.
Ma'am.
Okay,
yes,
so for
ma'am.
Pronouns are first person pronouns, second person personal pronouns, and third person personal pronouns. Why it is called a personal pronoun? Because it represents a person. Okay,
person.
We are using it to show a person. See, I is a person, you is a person, we is a person, right?
Yes, ma'am.
No, no. So it represents yes, persons, different persons. Okay. So the person who is speaking in a sentence is said to be the first person pronoun. I am your English grammar teacher. Okay. I am Miss Anjuvi Menon. Okay. I use I because I am speaking here. You are my close friends. Okay, you are my close friends. Here I am talking, but am I talking about me?
No.
No, I am talking about some other person, another person, right? So you
yes.
is an example for a person speaking to. Okay, here, see, you are a smart boy, Edwin Saji. You're sitting in a room. It is good ventilated. And also you are in class 6C. See, I am the person who is speaking to Edwin Saji. So not a first person, I am speaking to a second person, right? Edwin Saji is a second person here, right? Because I am not about talking about me, I am talking about a second person, that is Edwin Saji, okay? So I used the pronoun you to call that particular boy, right? And
yes.
now I am standing here and I am going to speak about, I am going to speak to Edwin Saji. I am the speaker. I am speaking to Edwin Saji. We are going to speak about Fida Fatima. Okay. So I am the first person. Edwin Saji is the second person.
Fida Fatima.
We are talking about another person. Okay. Not about me. I am not talking about Edwin Saji. We are talking about Fida Fatima, a third person. Okay.
Yes.
So Edwin Saji, she is a very beautiful girl. Edwin Saji, she is a very beautiful girl. So she, the pronoun is used to show a third person, right? Person spoken of. Am I clear? So the person
yes,
speaking,
ma'am.
The person speaking in a sentence is said to be first person pronoun. Okay, first person personal pronoun. The person speaking to is a second person pronoun. The person spoken of is a third person pronoun. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Should I repeat it?
Yes. No, ma'am.
Should I repeat it, Vaiga?
Yes, ma'am.
Should I repeat this? First person, second person, and third
no,
person?
No, ma'am.
You have a clear idea, right?
Yes.
Okay. So, children, so there are three persons, and all these personal pronouns are classified under three persons and two numbers. Okay. The two numbers are singular number, which represent one, and plural number more than one. At the same time, we have three persons, person speaking to, and person spoken of. Okay, I is the first person example, you is a second person example, and she, he, they are the third person example. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
So remember, based on the position, see, we need to face all these pronouns in a sentence, right? Yes or no? We are
yes,
using
ma'am.
These pronouns
yes,
sometimes
ma'am.
In the beginning yes, of a sentence, sometimes towards the end of a sentence, sometimes in the middle of a sentence, right? Somewhere in a sentence, we are using this. So based on the position of the sentence, we are labeling it under three cases. Okay? There are three cases under pronoun. Pronouns are classified
nominative.
Under three cases.
Nominative case,
yes.
Nominative
yes.
case, objective
case. Listen, the first case is said to be the subjective case pronouns. Second one,
objective
case pronouns. And third one, possessive case pronoun. I hope that this is a familiar topic for you guys.
Yes,
let
ma'am.
Us see. Let us see. Let us see. Let us share this point first. Words which represent persons are coming under personal pronouns. Okay? They stand for three persons. As I have told you, they stand for three persons. Example, the first person pronoun, the speaking, the person speaking. Example, I and we. Okay? second one, the second person pronoun, that is the person spoken to.
You.
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 Third one, the person spoken of.
Of.
He or she.
She or
they. It. Whatever it is. Okay. Now let us see the next one. We are going to learn about the first person pronoun once again. Okay. The pronouns which denote the person or person speaking are said to be personal pronouns of the first person. The examples for personal pronouns: I, me, my, mine, our, ours, us, we. See, look at the boy here. Look at the boy here in the picture. He is talking. What he say? Sorry.
Sorry.
Okay.
Sorry.
He is the one who is saying a sorry, right? So the sorry, I am sorry, is an example for, or I is an example for a personal pronoun, first person. Look at the boy. He is actually giving us a sorry. I don't know why he is saying a sorry. Maybe for arranging a grammar class for you. Okay. So please look at here. I am sorry. Here I, the pronoun, is an example for first person. Because here the person, this boy is the person, he is speaking here. Okay. So I is an example for a first person pronoun. Okay. Look at the second sentence. The doctor polished my teeth. The same boy is saying that doctor polished my teeth. So who is the speaker here? The boy is the speaker, right? Boy. So he is talking about his condition, his teeth, or his teeth was actually polished by a doctor, right? He is the speaker. No one else is speaking. He is the only speaker here. Now, look at what this boy says. We are happy here. Okay, the boy says that we are happy here in the grammar classes. Are you all agree with this concept? Are you all happy in the grammar classes or getting bored? Tell me the truth. Are you getting bored or are you happy in the grammar classes?
Happy.
Everyone?
I'm happy.
Everyone?
I'm happy.
Yes, I'm happy.
You should be happy. Otherwise, I'll become dull.
Interesting.
Okay. Interesting. Very good. Jovel, what about you, Jovel? Are you able to follow the class?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, very fine. I'm just talking. Danai Krishna, what about you? Are you following the grammar classes?
Yes, ma'am.
Ananda, are you able to digest?
Yes, ma'am.
Why your mother is standing at the back and laughing?
Ma'am, nothing.
Something wrong happened at home. You skipped your breakfast.
No, ma'am.
What happened there?
Nothing happened.
Nothing happened. I think you are very naughty boy. So you have done something, some naughty. No, whatever it is. Okay, have. So Pranava, your video is off. Pranava, your video is off.
Ma'am.
I think you have gone to LKGA. Come back.
No,
don't be a Priya, be a Pranava here in the class. Okay, so listen, children, we are talking about pronouns, person speaking. Okay, so the boy said, I am sorry. The boy said, we are friends. The boy said, the doctor polished my teeth. If only one tooth, okay, if only one, then you can say tooth. Okay, more than one, it is teeth. Singular tooth, plural teeth. Okay, so doctor polished the teeth. So this, the words like I, the pronoun like we, the pronoun like my are examples for first person. We are using to using to set a sentence, or the pronouns are used to show a first person account. Okay, Devak Menon also very happy. I think you're getting some comments from your parents. Okay, so repeatedly again. Yes, Ahil Samir. Ahil, what happens?
Nothing.
Ahil,
nothing.
What do you want to share?
Nothing.
You are sharing some messages and some dashes. Fill in the blanks. Give me one example with a personal pronoun. Anyway, you put a dash. Samir. Okay. So Ahil, Samir, fill in the blanks.
With the person.
An appropriate personal pronoun, first person.
I.
Okay. I don't want a word. I want a sentence, my son.
I ate breakfast today.
My God. It's time for lunch already. You're not helping your father and mother for making it. So soon after this class, go to the kitchen and support your mother. Okay. So again, I want a sentence. Hridin. You're growing your hair. Okay. Hridin, you please give me a sentence with first person pronoun.
Ma'am?
You give me a sentence with first person pronoun.
First person
pronoun. Use a first person pronoun in your sentence. I want an example. Anyway, you got 100 out of 100. Don't think too much. Look at the examples written here. Poor boy. See, it's exactly look like a Hridan Finnell, right? Look at his hair matching. See, Hridan Finnell is saying a sorry here. Sorry, ma'am. Sorry, ma'am. Here you are the speaker, Hridan. This little boy with the tie is actually you.
Ma'am.
Hridan, look at the example.
I am making the food in kitchen.
Sorry, the doctor polished my teeth. We are happy here.
I am saying example. I am making the food in kitchen.
I am making the food. So you're not attending my grammar class? You're there in the kitchen?
No, ma'am.
Okay, so fine. That's okay. I am making or I am helping my mother in the kitchen. Okay, fine. Good example. So what is the first person pronoun used in that sentence, Hridan?
Ma'am?
First person pronoun used in the sentence.
Ma'am, I.
Wonderful. I. Okay, so I request Edwin Saji. Anyway, I said you are the second person. My little second person, please tell me a sentence with first person.
I was talking with my friend.
See, leave I. I got one example from I. There are
can
many
I?
First person pronouns.
Ma'am, can
ma'am?
I?
Yes.
Can I?
Anusri.
Ma'am, can I?
Ma'am. Ma'am, can I say?
Anusri.
Can I, ma'am?
Ma'am.
And
then can I
can hear many can
ma'am
I's.
Joyal.
So I will put all the can I's in a can and I'll go for Prayag. Prayag? Prayag, please give me a sentence, first person pronoun. In your sentence, you should use a first person pronoun. Okay, don't use a I. I is a first person pronoun, but I got many examples. Please skip I and use some other words. You have we, you have my, you have mine. These are all coming under the first person pronoun. Why can't you use this?
He is my friend.
He is my friend. Who is your friend? Devak Menon. Abhimanyu.
Ma'am, can I?
Felix Naijo.
Ma'am, can I say Vaiga?
Ma'am, can I tell
yes, Vaiga?
Can Pia?
Ma'am,
Vaiga? Vaiga?
Yes, ma'am.
I am hearing you.
We were playing Ludo.
Ludo, can you include me in that game?
Yes.
Yes, I want blue coins, okay? So please listen,
ma'am,
we are playing Ludo. Myself, Vaiga, Angeline Relix, and Rena Fatima. We four are playing.
Ma'am.
See, now one more person, Abhimanyu. We four are going to play Ludo today. Okay, so personal pronouns. Okay,
ma'am,
now let's see the first person pronoun. I think the first person pronouns are very clear for you guys, right?
Yes,
so you can use I. You can use me, you can use my, you can use mine, our, us and we to make a sentence with first person or first person sentence or first person pronoun used in sentences. If you use these words, these are examples for first person pronouns. Okay, so let us see. Is it time to wind up?
Ma'am, only one more minute.
Let's see. Second person pronoun. Let us see. I don't know. Let's see. Second person pronoun. Yes?
Ma'am, it's 5 more minutes.
Five more minutes. So second person pronoun, I said the person who is actually I'm speaking to. See, two boys are. See, one the boy who is wearing a pants, he's talking to a boy who is wearing a trouser. Right? So second person. First person is boy with yellow t-shirt. Second person is the boy with red t-shirt. So two persons. He is talking to another person. Second person. Okay? I think this exactly the face look. Anthony Joyal is in yellow. And Abhimanyu is in red shirt. Okay? Let us see what is going to happen here. The person which denotes a person or person spoken to is said to be personal pronouns of the second person. Examples. You, your, yours are the examples for second person pronouns. Okay. Have you finished your homework? Okay. The boy who is wearing a yellow t-shirt is asking to the red t-shirt, have you finished your homework? Have you finished your homework? The boy who is talking is asking to the next person whether he has completed. So what will be his answer? if I ask you this question to Pranav or Prasad. Pranav, have you finished your homework?
Yes, ma'am.
Why are you talking about this all the time? Why can't we go for playing, right? You're always bothered about the homework and all. Why can't we go for playing, right, Pranav?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, we'll go for playing. Okay. After that evening, you spend half an hour or 1 hour for completion of all the homework. Once the online class is over, you can go for playing. Okay. So please look at here. Have you. So here you and your are the second person pronoun because one person is talking to the other person. Address, the person addressed here is a second person. Okay. Did you study for your test? Again, another question. Pranava is asking a question to Vaiga. Did you study for your test? Yes, of course I did. Right. Did
yes,
you?
Ma'am.
So Pranava is the first person. She is talking to Vaiga, the second person. And what question she asked? Vaiga, did you study for your test?
Yes.
Did you study for your test, Vaiga? Did you study
yes,
for
ma'am.
Your test?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay, now look at here. I am talking to you, children. See, I am the person to whom am I talking? I am talking to you children. So you is actually the second person. So if you use you, your, yours in a sentence, you can tell that the pronouns are used in the form of a second person pronoun. So Ananda, totally disturbed. So I want to get some answers from you. Frame a sentence with second person pronoun in it.
Okay, ma'am. I am your friend.
Sure.
Yes,
don't
ma'am.
Cheat me.
No, ma'am.
Should I believe you?
Yes, ma'am.
So, Daniel, I want ma'am. A sentence from you.
Ma'am.
Use a second person pronoun.
I like your toy.
My toy. I'm not ready to give it to you. I won't share. If I am a good friend, definitely I should have to share with you. Okay. Okay. Today.
Our failure.
Failure.
Yes,
recording.
If Punjabi is the host.
Ma'am said to leave.
Ma'am said to leave.
The WhatsApp group.
Bye
bye. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you all.
Bye, ma'am.
Thank you all.
Bye bye. I'm leaving.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Bye. Now I need students.
Bye. Bye.
Children, you can leave now. Children, you can leave now as your time okay, finished. Now next okay, batch is coming. Okay, I request all the children okay, to leave the meeting now. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.